I guess we're back with Barney, so what we want to remember with this dog is his obedience, if anything, before was very situational. And I'm not even sure it was that. So I've got to be ready. Honestly, with my actions to say, you know, who I am. So I haven't said heel or anything yet. But what happened was he got out and started sniffing every pole and completely ignoring me. All right, there's my pager. You precious, precious boy. So remember, this is the dog that's got the little musical treats. Oh my God, my the little bit of hinky freezing with the collar. So, and it's gonna take, I mean, I need to find out more, Carol, about what happened with him, but how long, you know, it went on. But it's working out. It's working out. I'm working the behavior out. You can still see it. I want you to watch him very closely when I hit this pager. What happened was his ear just sort of... said to me, well, he already knows how to heal and all that. Oh, you precious, precious boy. I would say it's not that that's becoming the problem. It's the fact that the environment is more interesting than the person.
You're fine.
I'm right there. That was click, click, click. So the byproduct of me doing that is... All right, there's my pager. There's my pager. Holding it, holding it. The byproduct of me doing that was a dog that started healing on his own. Was with dog trainers that I see, like on YouTube, failure to see the bigger picture. Failure to see the bigger picture. Focusing on little specific tasks and then failing to see, you know, right now if I'm trying to correct the dog, make it heal and do all this, that's not helping my big picture. Tell you how he's doing. He's doing absolutely perfect, I guess.